Recently started hearing about this whole snail and beauty products thing. It's very popular in Korea, but all I could think was, ugh, snail. That's so gross. All I could imagine was a snail sliming across my face. But of course, I had to do my research and find out why it was so popular. And I found out that, of course, snail is really great for your skin. So stay tuned in this episode of WTF Beauty and see if I love snail secretion or if I hate it. So I am absolutely naked faced right now. I have absolutely no makeup on, no skincare on, nothing. Today I'm testing out these snail face masks. I've heard about snail face masks a little bit just through some of the Korean beauty websites I read on and, you know, seeing them in dramas and things like that. But I'm actually going to be trying it out for myself today. So I'm using Sea Tree Art Snail mask sheet. Now this actually does contain snail secretion. It's right here in the ingredients. It says snail secretion filtrate, which essentially means filtered snail slime. I don't know if you guys can see it right there, but it's for real. Snail secretion is supposed to increase production of collagen, elastin, and dermal components, minimize damage from free radicals, and prevent premature aging. Just to explain kind of the condition of my face before I try the product out. Right now my face is extremely irritated, if you can't tell. I have been having a little bit of a breakout going on lately, so I was using a particular product, trying it out and seeing if it would help treat my skin as far as the acne goes, but it ended up really irritating my skin. I don't know why this is happening, but you can really see it on this side of my cheek. You can see it's kind of red and irritated. And it's basically just dry, like it just feels kind of dry. So this is kind of a good opportunity to try out this product because, you know, snail is supposed to be good for your skin. I'm gonna go ahead and put my hair up and get it out of my face so I don't get any snail slime in it. Kind of freaked out, honestly, I'm really nervous. I have yet to try these out, look at them. I haven't even really read reviews on them yet, so I don't even know if they're good. But let's get started. So if you've ever dealt with a snail mask or a sheet mask in general, you just open the packet up. Well, we know it's got a lot of essence in it. And you just pull out the little mask. So you just unfold it and you get a mask like this. Ooh, it smells good. Actually, it smells super fresh. It doesn't smell like slime or anything, but honestly, okay, I use sheet masks, and I know that the texture of sheet masks tend to be slimy, but the sliminess of this sheet mask is kind of making me nervous, but I already started the video, so I might as well as do this, no chickening out now. So here we go. I'm gonna look so crazy. And this is hard to do because I'm using my viewfinder and my camera. I'm not using a mirror. So I don't really know what I'm doing as far as placement goes. And I usually have a problem with face masks because they never fit my face properly because I have a small face. Lucky's unamused by this evidently. Ooh, it's really liquidy, which I guess it's supposed to be, but it's like really liquidy. I feel like it's more liquidy than normal. Like with normal sheet masks, I feel like they're thicker in consistency, the liquid that goes on the sheet masks. Anyways, okay, so I've got it placed according to the instructions on the back of the packet. I'm supposed to leave this on for 15 to 20 minutes, so I'm gonna go ahead and do that. It already feels really nice and cooling on my skin like any sheet mask would, so I will wait that time and I will come back and update you when I am done with my face mask. I look so crazy! And while I was waiting for my face mask to dry, I entertained myself by Do I look beautiful? Huh? Do I look beautiful, Lucky? Thank you. You're so sweet. Goyangi. Goyangi. My dad's outside mowing the lawn right now, and he just saw me. He's like, "What the heck? I'm so embarrassing." Okie dokie, artichokey. So I have left this on for about 20 minutes now, and I'm gonna go ahead and take it off. So,
And as you would with any sheet mask, you want to just kind of pat the essence into your skin. It's a little hard to tell right now as far as how it worked on my skin, but it did feel really nice and refreshing and cooling, which is really comforting on that patchiness and redness I had where my skin was really irritated from that product I'd been using. So what I usually do with the rest of the essence that's left on the sheet mask is I actually just kind of use it on the rest of my body.
Use it all up.
That was actually a very pleasant experience for me. I would definitely do that again. I am looking forward to seeing if this has any long-term benefits. If you want to kind of follow this whole experiment I'm doing with the snail mask, you can go ahead and check my website for any updates that I do on if I have any further long-lasting benefits from the sheet mask. But overall, I'm really happy with the mask. I really enjoyed the whole, you know, process of it and everything like that. I will see you guys in my next video, and thank you for watching. Also, let me know what you think of the series and if you'd like to see more of these type of videos. Bye, guys!
If you've ever tried any snail products, let me know in the comments down below and what you thought of them. I love to hear your recommendations.